Welcome to Recap King. In this video, we will explain Shark, The Beginning. This movie tells the story of a bullying victim who was imprisoned in a boys' prison due to an unexpected incident. He then meets a mixed martial arts champion and breaks his limit one by one to seek revenge and make his bully pay. Will he manage to become a tough man in prison? Let's find out in Shark, The Beginning. Shark, The Beginning begins when the youngest MMA champion from South Korea named Do-yoon is about to return home. However, when he gets home, he is shocked when he finds out that his mother and younger sister have died covered in blood. Shortly after that, he is attacked by a band of robbers who have killed his family. Since Do-yoon is a professional fighter, he can easily beat them. However, as he is filled with a burning rage, he ends up killing the three robbers, which in turn causes him to end up in prison. Elsewhere, a high school student named Woo-sol is in his classroom. Woo-sol is a weak and geeky young man, where he was often the victim of bullying when he was in middle school. That day, Woo-sol's class has a new transfer student named Sok-chan, a boxer who became a national champion in a high school boxing tournament. Even though all the students seem impressed with Sok-chan's boxing achievements, Woo-sol seems a bit uncomfortable with his presence in his class. It turns out that Sok-chan and Woo-sol had attended the same school in middle school, and Sok-chan was the one who always bullied Woo-sol. When he saw that Woo-sol was also in the same class as him, Sok-chan looked excited to bully him again like he used to. Sok-chan even blatantly bullies Woo-sol in front of their classmates. As if he had a personal grudge against Woo-sol, he didn't hesitate to beat and kick him. Even though the other students witnessed his cruelty, no one dared to stop his brutal actions that bullied Woo-sol. In the end, Woo-sol grabs the pen lying on the floor and tries to get up. He then points the sharp tip of the pen at Sok-chan, trying to defend himself from his attack. Threatened by Woo-sol, who he thinks is weak, Sok-chan even arrogantly challenges him to stick the pen's tip into his eye. However, his estimate that Woo-sol would not dare to do that turned out to be very wrong. Woo-sol desperately stabs the sharp pen's tip into Sok-chan's right eye until it bleeds. Afterwards, he is sentenced to 3 years in juvenile prison for the attack. In prison, Woo-sol befriends Yoon-min, who was sent to prison along with him. Woo-sol and Yoon-min are then briefed by one of the senior inmates about the strata of power in prison, where the most powerful inmates lead several groups. One of the strongest among them is Sang-yeob, who has considerable influence in prison. But for the time being, Sang-yeob has to serve his sentence in solitary confinement because he got into a fight with other powerful inmates, Won-joon and Sung-yong. Woo-sol is then told that there is a much stronger convict than the three of them, but he prefers to be alone, namely Do-yoon, a former MMA champion. The next day, while the prisoners play soccer on the field, Won-joon and Sung-yong intend to bully the new inmates, including Woo-sol. They then ask the new inmates to fight their group. However, an unexpected incident occurs when Woo-sol accidentally kicks the ball towards Won-joon's vital organs, causing the man to fall on his knees in pain, and the other inmates laugh at him. As a result of his actions, Won-joon then intends to avenge Woo-sol by torturing him. When Won-joon and his men bring in Woo-sol, they cross paths with Do-yoon, and Woo-sol has the idea of asking Do-yoon for help. Woo-sol immediately runs away from Won-joon and his men, then chases after Do-yoon and begs him to help him. At first, Do-yoon refuses, but out of pity, he asks Won-joon and his men to let him go. Won-joon doesn't accept Do-yoon's orders and asks him not to interfere in his affairs. Since Do-yoon doesn't budge, Won-joon attacks the MMA champion, where Do-yoon can easily dodge his attack and knock him down with just one light punch. Woo-sol was stunned by Do-yoon's ability. One day, Sok-chan visits Woo-sol in prison, where he blames him for everything that happened in his life after he injured his eye. Sok-chan had to bury his dream of becoming a professional boxer because of the poor condition of one eye. Because of that, he has the ambition to destroy Woo-sol and threatens him that he will keep waiting for him to get out of prison and take revenge. Even though Woo-sol has tried to apologize to Sok-chan, but he will never forgive Woo-sol for destroying his dream, and in return, Sok-chan will destroy Woo-sol's life. Not only does he get pressure from Sok-chan, Woo-sol also often gets bullied by Won-joon and his men. Tired of being bullied by the people around him, Woo-sol is determined to become stronger to stand up for himself and no longer be abused. He then walks up to Do-yoon, who is exercising, and begs him to teach him to fight like him. At first, Do-yoon ignores Woo-sol's request, but after Woo-sol pleads with tears and tells of all the bullying he's been through so far, Do-yoon agrees to help him. First, Do-yoon has Woo-sol run around the field for 100 laps. Woo-sol tries to finish the exercise despite his physical weakness, though he has to stumble and fall up and down from exhaustion. Seeing the sincerity of Woo-sol's determination to do his training, Do-yoon finally believes that he is really serious about his request. Do-yoon then asks the warden for help to allow Woo-sol to train in his cell. Since then, Woo-sol has started training in Do-yoon's cell in the field for a certain amount of time to become stronger. As time goes by, Woo-sol spends his days in prison training hard. All kinds of strenuous physical exercise was carried out in earnest, and the portion of his meal increased as the calories expended during exercise increased. Not only physical training, Do-yoon also teaches various techniques in combat. On the other hand, Sok-chan decides to drop out of school because he feels that his life has been ruined after Woo-sol's incident injured his eye with a pen. While being involved in a fight with several men, Sok-chan is visited by a mafia boss who is interested in his brutal fighting style and intends to recruit him as his team. Sok-chan didn't waste this opportunity either. Meanwhile in prison, Yoon-min is being bullied by Won-joon's men until Woo-sol arrives who intends to help him. Won-joon's men initially belittle Woo-sol and taunt him, but Woo-sol manages to prove that his training with Do-yoon has not been in vain. Woo-sol can knock out Won-joon's men with just a few light strokes. Won-joon's men then report the beating by Woo-sol to the boss, where Won-joon immediately orders him to come to see him. Woo-sol comes to the warehouse to meet Won-joon, who is very upset by his beatings to his men. He then orders Woo-sol to respect and bow to him. Because Woo-sol refuses, Won-joon then raises his fist at him. Unexpectedly, Woo-sol avoided Won-joon's bogey and spontaneously punched him in the face until he fell down. This suddenly makes Sung-yong and Won-joon's men stunned. Unable to accept being hit by the new inmate, Won-joon retaliates with a vengeance, making it difficult for Woo-sol to hold him back and lie on the floor. Won-joon, who thought he had beaten Woo-sol, looks pleased and turns around, but it turns out that Woo-sol is still able to get up and immediately lunges at him by banging his head hard on his face, so that he immediately collapses. Seeing Won-joon already lying helpless, Woo-sol still doesn't stop his action from beating him, until in the end, Do-yoon arrives to prevent him from taking further action. The two of them then left from there. Elsewhere, the mob boss who recruited Sok-chan seemed satisfied with his brutal work style. A few days later, while Woo-sol is practicing, Do-yoon tells him that today is the last day they practice together because tomorrow Do-yoon will be transferred to another prison. Even so, Woo-sol continues to practice hard every day, according to what Do-yoon has taught him. After Do-yoon leaves, Sung-yong comes up to Woo-sol and challenges him to a fight, but Woo-sol refuses because the real reason he fights is to defend himself, not to show strength. At the same time, Sang-yeob has been released from solitary confinement and decides to befriend Woo-sol. Not long after that, Sok-chan visits Woo-sol in prison again after hearing the news that he has now turned into someone who is good at fighting. Sok-chan, who came with one of his men, did not hesitate to intimidate Woo-sol and said he was not afraid of his transformation and was looking forward to fighting him. Sok-chan feels very confident because he has now become a gangster who is greatly feared because of his ferocity. Long story short, Sung-yong and his henchmen had been waiting for Woo-sol to come to fulfill his challenge some time ago. But before that, Sang-yeob and his men go up to Sung-yong and ask the man to stop the fight because they think it's pointless. But Sung-yong ignores Sang-yeob's words, especially now that Woo-sol has come and will fulfill his challenge. Woo-sol then puts a condition on Sung-yong before fighting. If he wins, then there should be no more fighting in the prison. But if Sung-yong wins, then Woo-sol will do whatever he wants. Sung-yong accepted the terms. Sung-yong and Woo-sol's battle is fierce, with both of them doing their best. On one occasion, Sung-yong managed to knock Woo-sol down to fall to the ground. However, Woo-sol keeps trying to get up and finally manages to lock up Sung-yong's movement, forcing the man to give up. Sung-yong then admits that he lost rather than strangled death by Woo-sol. Meanwhile, Woo-sol was thrown into solitary confinement as punishment for his actions. After finally being released from solitary confinement, Woo-sol and Sang-yeob then come to Sung-yong to collect his promise because he has lost the fight. Won-joon also agrees to reconcile with Sang-yeob and Woo-sol. Sung-yong kept his promise and since then, there has never been a fight between the inmates again. 3 years have passed, and finally the day of Woo-sol's release has arrived. Woo-sol welcomes a new day as a free man after so long in prison with a glimmer of hope. However, before he has stepped far into his freedom, Sok-chan has been waiting for him and challenged him to a fight right then and there. The two of them then headed to the field to fight more freely. Overwhelmed with anger and ambition for revenge, Sok-chan immediately launched a blind attack on Woo-sol, without giving him the slightest chance to strike back. On one occasion, Woo-sol was able to counterattack by punching Sok-chan in the face, but this only made Sok-chan's anger even more intense and he then beat Woo-sol out. Even though he had fallen several times, Woo-sol kept trying to get up. Musall mustered all his remaining strength to fight Sok-chan with a battered body. They both threw fatal blows at each other until in the end the fierce duel was won by Musall, after Sok-chan tried to withstand the final blow that Musall threw at him. Exhausted, Sok-chan cannot counterattack, and Musall chooses to leave him, rather than make him do nothing. The film ends by showing Musall visiting Do-yoon in prison. He is grateful for all the training and valuable lessons that Do-yoon gave him during their time in prison. Musall then reveals that his life is now for the better after mastering martial arts as taught by Do-yoon. Even now he has been recruited by a mafia boss to become a debt collector, thanks to his fighting skills. The film ends.